Good evening, everyone. I'm Paul Legron. It's great to be with you here on this busy Thursday night. And we've seen it all across the country, events turning into super spreaders for COVID-19. And tonight, a new report out from the CDC says that an amateur hockey game right here in the Tampa Bay area sparked an outbreak earlier this summer. ABC Action News reporter McKenna King tonight with brand new details on how many people got sick and why the CDC is now using this local case as an example for the rest of the country.
While there's no precise medical definition of a super spreader, the general consensus...
An event where a single individual results in the infection of multiple secondary contacts.
That's exactly what happened at a hockey game in the Bay Area back in June.
We're still learning a lot when it comes to super spreaders. Experts believe the majority of COVID-19 transmission has come from a small group of people. In the case of the local hockey game, experts believe one person or one super spreader went on to infect 14 other people. That's more than half of the people inside that arena that day.
The facility unnamed, but that game outlined in the CDC's Morbidity and Mortality Weekly Report. And experts say this situation is not uncommon. They believe super spreaders are responsible for the majority of COVID-19 cases.
They're awfully contagious people.
The problem is there's no real way to identify them.
Probably about 1 in 300 or 1 in 500 people that are walking around out there in Hillsborough County right now or possibly in our state are super spreaders.
So your best bet to avoid infection is limiting how many people you're around.
I think it's, you know, fairly safe to do these sports in empty arenas.
But as was the case with that June hockey game, which was inside an empty arena where one person infected more than half of the players and an ice rink staff member, there's always a risk.
But then if you fill that arena with 25,000 people, chances are you're going to have a super spreading event there.
In Tampa, McKenna King, ABC Action News.